What's up, everybody? Destroyer here. Welcome back to the Lord of the Skyrim's Berethor's Quest. The Skyrim playthroughs will rule them all. We are on part 18. Of course, we are continuing the quest of the Forgotten City.
Got my eye on ya.
But yeah, like I was saying before, why are there armed guards? If anyone even strikes anyone, everyone dies. So why would you need armed guards? Yeah, doesn't make sense, does it? Alright. Dragonstone, let's not steal that. Just out of curiosity, if I steal anything, maybe that's why everything is marked steal. We're all still alive? Just wandering eyes. What the hell is going on here? Hello.
I'm a little busy, but what do you need?
Do you know a way out of here?
I got myself trapped in here for a good reason. No way I'm going back up there. So, no, I don't
know. Okay, whatever.
What? You think if you butter me up, I'll start making food for you, too? Forget it. My kitchen's for Citadel residents only. Go make your own food.
I just want to talk to you.
Well, fine. My story? I'm the Citadel cook. In this life. Not exactly how I thought my life would end up. But it's better than it was on the
There's going to be a lot of talking. I might have to skip a lot of dialogue. So I do apologize, but we'll be here a while if I don't. What is life like on the surface?
That.
An easy life for myself and Mark Garth, married to silver merchant. Maybe it was a little too easy. I was bored.
Started a lot. Started looking for something to do.
Everyone reads very slowly.
A friend introduced me to Skooma. It was. Mm-hmm. I was a living cliche. Lost my husband, my home. If I couldn't keep myself away from the Skooma, I'd have to keep it away from me. So when haven't touched the stuff since. Still get the cravings. Sometimes I
have
kill
some skooma.
One last bottle. But no point in thinking about it down here. Right.
Should I?
Is that what I think it is? Can I have it?
I need something from you first.
Whatever you want. I could give you food or information. You find out all sorts of secrets being the chef in a place like this. Will that do?
Sure. Tell me a secret about this place.
Well, there's Marius. He's growing plants in his room that can really only be used for making poisons. Not sure what he's up to, but it's nothing good.
Marius. On second thought, I think I'm hanging on to it. Should I give her skooma? That seems like a terrible idea. But I might do it. Tell me another secret.
Have you met Saphira and Domitus downstairs? Saphira despises that rude bastard. I don't blame her. Not that she'd ever say it to his face.
What?
I think I've told you enough already. Now, are you going to give me the skooma or not?
All right.
My God, that's good. A little weak. Heavy on the nightshade. Light on the moon sugar. But it feels like home.
Jesus.
Ooh, now, I'd better finish up in the kitchen before the hallucinations really kick in.
What have I done? Just drugged up their chef. Who came down here to escape skooma. I am a terrible, terrible human being. Did it get darker? I thought it was pretty light. Did I kill everybody already? Maybe when I stole that plant, I might have, People are still alive. Phew. Okay, that's good. So we got some important info. Some guy is growing poison plants, and someone else hates someone. Well, we know who that is already. Alright, we'll check out the poison dude, I guess. Who is... inform Metellius that Marius is a threat. What if he isn't, though? Identify the person most likely to destroy the city. Form Marius. Talk to Brawl the Scholar to find out more about the city. Eh, find a way back to your original timeline. Alright. Can't imagine there's too much left to do in this place, but you never know.
Hello.
Who are you? I like our training in the art of speechcraft.
I'm Gretchen from Hyrak. I've studied history at the Imperial City, which led me to Skyrim in search of Dromer ruins. And now I'm here.
That accent, though.
I just can't believe my luck. Working with Bro, researching the richest source of Dromer history and technology I could have imagined. I feel like we're on the brink of some amazing discoveries about the Dromer. Who knows? Maybe we'll find not all of them have disappeared.
Can you tell about the history of this place?
I could. But Brawl knows much more than I do. You
That's
should
true.
Be able to find him in his chambers down the
do
city.
You need help with the research.
Now that you mentioned it, I do. I need you to get something for me, and it won't be easy. I've tried everything I can think of, and still nothing. There's a big Nord living down in the city called Rikus. You may have seen him walking around in an immaculate example of dragon armor. I need that armor. It's the only one like it, and I believe it to be crucial in unlocking the secret of this place. The trouble is, before I could get a good look at it, that brute Rikas claimed it as his own and has been wearing it ever since. I've tried everything. Appeals to his better nature, flattery, charm, even threats. It's like negotiating with a brick wall. The only thing I haven't tried is violence. And you know how that would end. But I'm convinced there's
the way she said negotiating got me. I'm not making fun of Raxa, but still, that was pretty funny.
Thank you. If you do manage to get it, you're welcome to keep it. I just need to have a quick look at it, that's all.
Alright, fair enough. I probably won't succeed, but we'll see. I could still go down and get that thing from the Undermine? The, what the fuck do you call it? The tunnels. I think I will, actually. I'll go see what's up in the tunnels, eh? Why not? Why did it get dark? It was very much not dark not too long ago. Unless I doomed everybody. Bugged it out somehow. Is there a day-night cycle in here? Oh, it's 7 p.m. Is there actually a day-night cycle in here? There is. How weird. I guess they get their light from the source, or the... Well, yeah, the source. The surface. That's what I meant. That's pretty strange. Okay. Hello, Brawl.
Hello, neighbor. Made any exciting new discoveries?
What's your story?
My story. What a... Well,
I don't really want to hear it, to be honest.
And finally, my story is really much less interesting than this mysterious place. Now, do you have any sensible questions, or can I get back to work? Well, why didn't you say so? I researched Dwarven history and now that's an interesting question. My thinking is that if there was a way out of here, the dwarves who built this place must have known about it.
They disappeared years ago, ages.
True. But we can learn all sorts of things about them from what they... And while I've discovered many things here, there are some parts of the city I haven't been able to get to. I'm most interested in the palace, above the lake. Unfortunately, it's sealed up tight. Only one man ever managed to enter, and he never came out. That was Narnabus, and we haven't heard from him in years. Strange fellow. I believe he was looking for the secrets of the dwarves too. If you could find a way in there, I'm sure it would tell us a great deal about this place. Time travel. You know, as it happens, I do. It was a great obsession of mine for years after... After my wife passed. I thought if I could go back, I gave up on that idea a long time ago. But recently the Jarl has asked to see my research note. Can I ask what the nature of your interest is?
Because I've traveled here from the future, I want to go back.
I don't quite know what to say to that. How can I put this charitably? But I always enjoy discussing my theories with a recipient.
If you traveled to the past, how would you return to the present?
For argument's sake, if you found yourself in that position, you'd have only two options. To live out your days in the past, or force a paradox. A paradox, you see, would involve changing the past so as to prevent the events which caused you to travel back in time in the first place. But you'd be taking a big risk by doing it. Some say that whatever you do, but me, I believe that creating a paradox should... Well, let's say for argument's sake that you really have traveled here from the future. You could create a paradox. Essentially, you could do anything. For example...
Yeah, I get it. I've achieved my goal.
I think it's best if we talk about something else.
What's the big spinning orb above us? Tell me what the law is. I'll be right now.
Very well. Come back if you think of any questions All right. about something you discover.
Firefly Finery, there's a store. Vernon's Fresh Produce. Just out of curiosity, what do they sell? Anything special?
What is it, Imperial? I'm the Jarl. The Jarl says he likes to keep us busy and out of trouble.
If you're also unfair, why don't you overthrow him? I'm sorry to hear that. Let's talk about something else.
Citadel never seen. All right.
Too bad. What do you have for sale?
Only the finest clothes in
town. And will you buy things? Yeah. I stole these in the future. Just say it. Well, it's a good thing he buys things that are not, just clothes, eh? What does he have? Dwarven Sword of Radiance. Scorches undead for 30 points of damage. That's pretty nice. I mean, it's not nice. The enchantment's nice. Kisling targets. Undead. Flee. Reduces target's attack damage for 30% for 4 seconds. Wow. Undead up 21. Flee. Does stamina damage. A glass elven helmet. Glass helmet of eminent alchemy. Huh. Seems he has some neat stuff. Lots of enchanted stuff. I don't think I'll be buying anything, but still cool to look, I guess. Amethyst and garnets. Buy my potato moonshine and my salmon steaks. For free.
See you again soon.
I hope not, actually. What's this? The Honest Trader. What's the Honest Trader have?
Hello, Imperial. What brings you down here among the rabble?
How does your story go?
My story? Well, my name is Degland, and I'm a merchant, yeah? What's people say to me? Degland, they say. Degland, why are you a merchant? They find it surprising because I'm such an honest and trustworthy person. And sometimes you hear about your merchants who are, you know, dishonest. Well, I say to those people, I'm not like them. My father used to say to me, Degland, you can't be like the others. You be a good boy. And I was,
my friend.
I was not only just a good boy, I was the best boy. The best wares for you, my friend.
What the fuck? Okay. He's the best boy, so let's just leave him to being the best boy. Let's take these gold ingots. And the lockpicks. And anything you can buy that I don't need? Steel dagger. Iron arrows. Forsworn arrows. Oh, yeah, I forgot we have exploding bolts. Shit, yeah. Buy that as well. I need not these trinkets.
Until next time.
Alright, best boy. Have a good one.
Oh, a new person.
Oh. Shut up. You bitch. Where is my house? He gave me a key to a house. I forget where it was. I'll find it. I'll check it out. Vernon's house. Must be on the other side, I would imagine. So that's the palace above the lake, eh? I don't know how the shit you get up there.
Be quick. Domitus could be back any second.
Maybe you go through the tunnels to get there? I gotta say, it's impressive architecture, at least. The dwarves definitely knew how to build some shit. Also, who the hell was the guy I was actually looking for? So I need the Immaculate Dwarven Armor from Rikus. Find a way to the Abandoned Palace. Marius is the threat. But he might not be the threat. What if I'm wrong? Also, I'm back here. Where's my home? It would certainly say, like, my house, right? Alright, well, let's go back around and find Marius' house. Or just fucking use the map. Abandoned palace, underground tunnels, lake house, sunken house. Ah. Chambers. There it is. Okay, where's the other guy though? Morris. Damn it. Miranda. Vernon. Rikus. So this is an abandoned palace there. That's gonna be curious. I don't see a Morris' house. Who's Morris? Well, I'll go check out my house and then I guess I'll just go underground. I guess it's that center one there. I can just go up here. Yeah. Lapis. Didn't quite work. As intended. Ow. Shit. Alright, let me do this. There we go. Oh yeah, let's talk to this guy real quick.
What do you want?
About the shiny dwarven armor you're wearing.
What about it?
Like to buy it from you, give it to me or I'll kill you and take it.
Not going to happen, maggot. Because you know, and I know. Oh, well in that case, you still can't have it. Let me be clear. It's not for sale. Nope. This is the only one like it in the whole city.
The hell of shit am I supposed to get it from him?
Bye.
Bastard. Well, screw that one. Guess I'm getting her armor, after all. Alright, this is my chamber, I guess. I was gonna say, it's pretty fucking small. It goes downstairs. Chest. Hey, comes the stuff. I like stuff. What? We have a chamber to the underground tunnels from our house. Interesting. Alright, I'm going into the underground tunnels now, I think. Maybe I'll actually get to kill something. I haven't got to stab anything for a while. Last thing I got to kill was a skeever, and that was like a while ago. Like an hour and 15 minutes ago. Alright. These shouldn't be collapsed. If they collapse in the future, they should be just fine now. Alright, I'm gonna quick save this beach. Ready my arms. I don't know what to expect, to be honest. We'll be down in the depths in this place. Strange energy radiates all around you. How interesting. I'm dying! Holy shit, it's radiation. Okay. Can I just heal through it? Probably not. That was draining my shit pretty quick there. I should probably... Well, I might have to fight this thing. What is this? It's too much. The healing has no effect. I think I need to discover it, have it pop up, find a way, etc., etc., and then walk away before I die. Well, that's interesting. It's one word I would use. Alright. Let's try this again. I don't think it actually gave me the quest. A magic anomaly. Alright, magic anomaly. You're the first thing I've got to kill in ages. Frostbite sucks. What about... What else we got here? We got raised wall. We'll build a wall and make this magic anomaly pay for it. Maybe not. Damn it. Am I doing it? Am I winning? Ah, there we go. Damn it. It's a hard one to hit. Common soul gem. With a soul, no less. I'm not quite sure how you actually do this. We're clearly gonna have to go talk to somebody about this. Maybe the dude would know. Oh my god. You die so fast in there. Shit. I heard the quest pop up though. So let's go in. And then get out. Okay. Lyandra's corpse. And Immaculate Dwarven Helmet. Talk to an expert about the Immaculate Dwarven Armor. Oh, is the Immaculate Dwarven Armor protect me from radiation? Is that what's gonna happen here? Makes wearer immune to radiation when worn as a complete set. Okay, I get it. Alright, so we need to go talk to, Chick. Well, no wonder you haven't come down here to get the stupid thing he sent me down here for. No one can get that thing. So we legit need that guy's suit of armor if we're ever gonna get down there. Huh. Well, at least we know who to talk to. Should I just tell him that Maris is the threat? I'll save and see what happens if I do that as well. Okay, I got the helmet as well.
What do you want?
What's your story?
Get out of my face. My problem is that I'm the only one around here whose head isn't buried in the sand. That's my problem.
It's almost like someone doing a bad Khajiit impression.
I mean, everyone acts like nothing's wrong, but we're one stupid mistake away from being wiped. Seems like I'm the only one ready for what's coming, whatever that is. And when it hits, I don't know. But did you ever get the feeling these statues are watching us? Like they're waiting? If I did, I wouldn't be...
Actually, let's ask him one more time about the armor.
What about it?
I need to complete the set.
Not my problem.
Come on, I want it.
Well, in that case, not going to happen.
Maggot. You're the worst.
Because you know, and I know.
Help! There's a looter coming into the city. I saw a man come down the shaft, but he was armed and he looked like a looter. If he makes it into the city and starts attacking people, he'll break the dwarves' law. And who knows what will happen? You have to stop him.
Why don't they have guards posted?
Everybody, go home and lock your doors.
Okay. No problem. I can kill a looter. So only if he's not in the city is fine? Fair enough. Then Berethor will help you. Assuming we might give him in freeze. There we go. Oops. Ooh, look at him. Thinking he's big and bad. Guess what? I got news for you, Rogar. You're dead, scum. Close. He was pretty close to the door. Is that it? Hey, let me turn my compass back on. Oh, there's more enemies. Oh, piss. Alright, stupid looter. You will die! Got him. Boom. How about that? What the fuck? Oh, I was gonna say, please don't tell me I'm in the wall. That would be really annoying. Alright, let's go for another shot. This one. Ooh, Jesus. She could be a problem. Oh boy. Oh god. She killed me. The fuck is she using? Big ol' fireballs. Feels good to get some action though. Not gonna lie. Oh god. Was this before I went in here? Okay. Use a shitty heal spell. Go Divine Light. There we go. That's the ticket. Wait, what was that? Was that ore? Aha! Got a keen eye! Alright. I'll save before I go in there this time. So I don't die. I hate dying. Dying sucks. Most people could agree with me, I think, on that. Alright. Oh yeah, let's put our helmet back on as well. Might as well get the extra armor. Actually, what does our armor go to when we take it off? 133 to 218 because we get a full complete set bonus. That's a huge difference. You'd think, oh, I'll just take my helmet off, but actually, taking my helmet off negates a lot of armor bonus I'm getting. Alright, we won't talk to this guy yet. How does she know? She's just like,
if he makes it into the city and starts attacking people, he'll break the dwarves' law. And who knows what will happen? You have to stop him.
Why would looters come down here? I guess they don't know there's no way out. Makes sense, I guess. I mean, quite frankly, I didn't know there was no way out. I was just like, okay, I'll jump down here. Gandalf, Legolas, and Boromir, though, are smart enough to not jump down here. But they are in another time, of course. Chill out. Yeah. Got Shrek'd. I guess I could take pretty much everything, mostly. Alright, what spells do we have? Frostbomb. Frostbomb's probably alright.
Tell you what, you start running so I can stab you in the back.
You bastard. Oh, he died. That's good. Brigand Dwemer chestplate. Storm armor. Interesting. It's got that ugly ass helmet as well. Alright, let's learn storm armor. Sounds cool. Forgotten magic. So it's one of those magics that level up as you use it. What is storm armor anyway? Would it be alteration? Probably, yes. Let's try it out. I have enough magic. Alright. Kill the son of a bitch. No problem. I'll take it all. Shit. Ooh, that's cool. Oh, they're jumping down. I see. Oh god, no, not again. Holy shit. This person just really... really hurts. I don't have enough. Ah! Fast healing. Super fast. Alright, let's be careful about this. Reloading force. Also do this. It's a good place to quick save, I think. Teehee! Alright, scum! Oh, it's this one I gotta worry about. Whoa! I thought it was the other one. Wow, she's so powerful! Did I just float up to the surface? No. Did she kill herself? Wow. Okay. We could, Phoenix strike there in there. Maybe hit him with the Krosis as well. I don't have enough magic. Come on! Ugh, Necrosis is not worth the amount of magic it takes. Wild mushrooms. What's that? Winter Woe. Oh god, that's... I know what Winter Woe is. I don't have enough magic to cast Winter Woe. Aw, it sucks. Okay, in that case, we're going in. Oh, evil twin. I forgot to channel it. Well, she took care of her evil twins pretty easily. Fuck. Damn it. Mage. Mages are my bane, apparently. Oh my god. If only I could summon the wall. But keep it there, you know? I'll paint the snow with your... There's no snow in here, you idiot. Alright, so I'm with the frost bomb. I'll do some damage, I guess. Come on, let me do this! Whoa! Jesus. Come on, now is our time! Kill one! Oh, yeah, got one. Whoa. These bandits. That's cool. I like that. Okay, well, the one of them's dead. Feels good. I'm just gonna get the other one. The other one's more dangerous, I believe. I think if I just get in there and get involved, I might just kill her off. I'll try. I mean, I could be wrong. I cannot take those fireballs. Fuck. Crazy. I could shoot her to death. And I do have a crossbow. Just gotta avoid getting hit. God, she's sending like nukes. Crazy shit. I can't even see her. So much fire. Aha! This seems to be working. Don't move. Oh, she moved. Damn you, woman! Oh, I got her. That's the ticket. Holy shit. I want to be that kind of mage. Crimson Archer. And the helmet to go with that chest piece that I got from the other person. Exploding steel bolts of fire. So now I'm gonna start finding them on people, huh? Oh, fuck! Dark Brotherhood Warlock. What? The fuck? Uh-oh. That means it's a mage. Won't he just start drowning? Well, you stay there. Stupid ass. I got all day. Right. Oh. Is that his glass sword? Dagger. Warlock's orders. So the Dark Brotherhood's trying to kill them? What? Warlock's orders. Where's that? My sweet child, if Quintus thinks he can hide from his own family, he's an even greater disappointment than I thought. He may have looted his other siblings, but I know you won't let me down as they did. Take some of your playthings and find out where the venomous little spider's hiding. And when you find him, sweetling, do what you must. M. Find Quintus and investigate whether he is a threat. So Quintus is a former Dark Brotherhood guy, eh? Huh. So he could be the threat as well. Like, if they got in there, that could have been the end. There's a guy making poison. He could be the guy. Of course, I still can't figure out where he lives. Who's Quintus? Let's see if we can find his house. Well, looking at everything. Quintus, Quintus, Quintus. Maybe some people don't have houses. I don't see Quintus's house. So maybe he lives in the Citadel.
Oh yeah. Is it over? Is it safe?
Loser dead.
Oh, thank the gods. What a relief. We're so lucky that you arrived in time to stop them. I'll be sure to tell everyone what you've done for us.
Question.
Thank you so much.
If I wasn't here, wouldn't they all die?
Ever anything my husband Tabik and I can do to help.
Isn't that why they died then? Because they would have gotten the city and attacked immediately, Quintus and everyone else. So if I wasn't here, that would have been the cause of everyone's death. So in theory, I should have solved it, but that's probably not the answer. What's your story?
Not that you don't look good now, I mean...
What are you doing?
What do you want?
You know, get nice up. Clothes.
Get out of my...
Oh,
my problem
is no that
I mean, seems like I'm the only one. I don't know. But
God, I hate this guy's voice.
I wouldn't. What about it?
I need it.
Not my problem.
Come on. Was the other girl hitting him? And I just started talking to a dude. I don't know. Weird. Alright. Maybe we'll hit up the tavern. Tavern might have a. Someone. These are all stores. Still haven't got the fucking layout in my head yet of how this place looks. I don't know where a few people live, though. So I'm assuming they live in the Citadel. Or they don't have a house. One of the two. Gilvar.
I heard you took down some... Well...
I don't care about your story, just...
My father, my mother, the lady...
Oh, God. Don't go on.
One... I...
It's a good thing I didn't decide to listen to him talk.
Well,
yes, it's tragic.
And then... Next thing I knew...
I see, so you have your own farm again?
I'm a farmer.
You don't sound happy about that.
But I... just do me a favor. Don't know why you're asking.
Why do I keep asking people? Do you know how to get out of here? They clearly don't. Okay. And you. I've talked to the Jarl.
I heard you took care of some looters for us. If only there was something I could do to thank you. Let me know if you think of anything.
Well, I can think of a few things. What's your story?
You want to hear about little old me? Aren't you adorable? But wouldn't you rather hear what I know about everyone else around here? Only one way out of this city, and that's through the bottom of a mug of moonshine, if you get me. So, but then again...
She's a very erotic voice, isn't she?
Very erotic. The Dunmer fellow, can't miss him. hit the drinks pretty hard after his wife just sits there night after night. Poor guy.
Do you have for sale?
Good luck. See anything you like?
Wait, she sells skooma? Oh, so you can actually buy skooma from her and give it to the other chick? I will buy it, actually. I don't know why.
Did you know that beautiful palace above the lake is sealed? Bross is the last person to go in there, locked it behind him. I wonder what's in there.
As do I.
Did you notice the big crack in the floor near the city gate? They say some poor fool fell to his death trying to scale the front of the citadel.
No, actually, I didn't.
Did you know there are tunnels running all the way under the city? Last one to go down there was Brandis, and it sent him to his deathbed. There's something creepy about Marius up in the citadel.
Oh, he's up in the citadel.
He never comes down to the tavern. And you just can't trust a man who doesn't drink.
What?
Nobody here locks their door, except the Jarl. I hear there's a locked room on the top floor of the citadel, but nobody's seen what's inside. Have you seen Rygus walking around in that shiny armor of his all paranoid? Like those dwarven statues are going to spring to life any minute.
Did the Jarl send you to steal it?
Yeah, about the statue stuff. Turns out he's correct. Turns out, yeah.
By the eight! I hear you took on a band of marauders by yourself, you buffoon! Next time, come and get me. I'll show him what for.
This guy's incredibly British.
Name's Castellus Vitus, military engineer of the Imperial Legion. Out of action right now, but don't worry, I'm still in the service. What about you?
I'm loyal to the Empire.
Excellent. Always a pleasure to see pure Imperial stock joining our ranks down here. Somebody's got to run the place, eh?
Yes, old chap.
Now, I expect you'll have questions about how this place runs.
You're not supposed to stand on chairs.
Happy to share what I've learned.
Okay.
What did you want to know?
What's been working on in your workshop?
Yes, my workshop.
Is it a workshop?
Well, of course, as an engineer through and through, I couldn't resist the urge to dismantle some of this dwarven technology. How complicated can it be, I thought. As it turns out, it's extremely complicated. You see these gleaming dwarven busts in every room? Well, I think I know what they are. They all seem to be connected to the pipes running all over the city and down the front of the citadel. And I've seen these things before in other ruins, but these are different. Their eyes are glowing with blue light. Have you noticed?
Nope.
But whenever you see one of these things, remember, someone or something is watching everything you do.
Yep.
Waiting for you to break the dwarves.
Have you noticed any suspicious behavior?
Behavior, you say? Ah, so the Jarl has found a task for you. Well, the Citadel's mainly full of good imp. Lately, I've been wondering if the Citadel isn't haunted. I'll be damned if I know where it's coming from, but it's not Gaia next door, so who could it be but a ghost? Gods know a lot of died in here. Yes, there's a single... But that's not... The dwarves were brilliant engineers. Jarl's dorm.
Uh-huh.
But it's a good idea to make yourself useful.
Alright, I'll be going now. Thank you. Did you say these have glowing blue eyes? Or these busts, maybe? Where are the busts? Up there. Probably the vision things. They're essentially security cameras, aren't they? It's like Big Brother. Alright. God. Find Quintus and investigate whether he's a threat. Inform Metellius that Golbar is a threat. Or ask Ulrin about the disappearance of his wife. There's a lot of things to do. A lot of options. Who the hell knows which one's the real one? I want to get that armor from that dude, but I can't. He won't give me it. Apparently there's a crack somewhere. Over in front of the palace here, or the place. I didn't notice it because I still don't see it. Oh, did he say in front of the palace? Or in front? No, he said in front of the this place. Also, what's in the sunken house? I still don't have a key for that. We're gonna talk to the guy with the poisons. Then we're gonna talk to the Jarl. Fuck, I might be in here for a couple sessions, actually. A few, rather. I've already been in here for a couple, haven't I? Or going to be, rather.
Not here. He can hear us.
Yeah, he can.
Well, I'm still... You do that.
You guys just have a nice day. Have a nice day, you asshole. Can you imagine if the Dragonborn fell into a hole and you couldn't get out? Well, the world's screwed. Dragonborn got lost in some dwarven city he couldn't get out of. Unfortunate. What's this? Oh, nothing. Is there anything in here? No. There's no door saying whose room is whose or anything. Okay. There's a door. What's this? Nightshade. This must be his room. Oh, he's the Dark Brotherhood guy, isn't he? Yeah. Don't worry, I stole your shit in the future. What the hell? This is just the other way. So, I mean, the Dark Brotherhood guy would have got everyone killed here. Realistically. But I feel that's too obvious. I'm maybe giving the mod author too much credit, but...
I hear you got to kill some looters. I'm just sorry I wasn't there to help.
So you're a Dark Brotherhood assassin. What?
Oh. So, you went through my belongings, did you? Well, what of it? What do you want?
Just want to make sure you're not the only threat to the safety of the city.
Oh, how noble of you. I've admitted it. I worked for the Dark Brotherhood, and I was very good at what I did. But I'm quite comfortable here, as you can see. What would be my motivation to kill anyone now? I'd need some kind of death wish. Now. Was there something else you wanted to... You do that.
Alright, he seems legit.
Oh, hello there.
Yep, that's all I need from you. Alright, I don't think it's him. Even though, like I said, those looters getting into the city would have actually killed everybody, so... technically his fault. But that's not the cause, somehow. Which has me... dumbfounded. Alright, well, I could just tell him something he wants to hear and hope for the best, or follow up on more clues. That's the kitchen, that's the balcony. Or is that the yeah. Ugh, I never have enough stamina. I want like a thing that just allows me to run forever. That'd be great. Just like a pendant that allows me to sprint permanently. Without fatiguing. That'd be awesome. What's in here? Most interesting. Alright, there's that. Nothing in there. That's his chambers. Wait, where'd you go? I guess he's in his office. I didn't see him. He might be asleep. What time is it? There he is. Alright, let's save. Give him a talk. Get out.
Hello again, my friend. Any word?
Can you clarify something?
What do you want me to clarify?
No.
I'll talk to you soon, I hope.
I know who's going to destroy the city.
Well, I hope your investigation has been thorough. I don't want you accusing the first person you suspect. So, who is it?
Gulvar, he's extremely angry with you and he has a history of violence. It's Marius, he's an assassin. See, those seem like really obvious.
Gulvar, Oh no. I always liked Gulver, but I saw the anger in him too. The sort of atrocity he experienced. It does something to a man. But still, we have to intervene and stop him. There's only one thing left to do. I need you to kill him for me. But you need to be discreet about it, so as not to break the dwarves' law. You see, I believe we're being watched by the dwarven statues and busts all around the city. But there are blind spots, areas where they can't see us. One of those areas is the tunnels below the city. If you can lure your ugly business, I know. But it's the only way to save my people. To save... Good. Thank you. Now, here's a key to the tunnels under the city. You can enter via... I knew I could count on you. Sometimes even...
I don't like that option. I don't feel like he's the bad guy. Fuck that. I think, actually, if you do have any tips for this quest, and you have played it before, I would actually not mind, having some tips. Not blatant spoilers, per se, if you have done this quest line or not, but I wouldn't mind having some direction, I suppose. Because I don't feel like he's the bad guy. Oh, it's you. You're an attractive young lass. You know a way out of here?
Well, as you know, the Jarl is my father. Or, at least, that's what he tells people. What he doesn't tell anyone is that I'm adopted.
Oh,
and the worst part is, I don't even know why he adopted me in the first place. I mean, he doesn't seem to care about me at all. Sometimes I feel more like his prisoner than his daughter. If we weren't trapped in here, I'd run away in a heartbeat.
Sounds very controlling.
He really is. He's always telling everyone what to do. I don't know how everyone puts up with him. Did you know he calls this place his citadel? And he and his friends don't do any work. Everything gets done by the people down in the city. He'll probably try to make you work for him too. But don't just do whatever he says. People around here should really learn to... You know my father would be upset to hear you ask that. I love it. Me, not even allowed out of the citadel. I'm so bored. Father doesn't want me mixing with the common folk. He's all, why don't you read one of the books Gaia brought you? Books. I'm almost 18. I want to have fun, like normal girls might.
Oh, you're not legal?
Let me
leave.
I thought about getting one of those awful Nord tattoos. Father would hate that. But then that bitch Asanchi told me about her skooma habit. I don't want to drink it. Oh, but if I get some, I just know I could get that junkie to spill her guts about everyone in this place.
I already did that.
Oh, well, there goes that idea. Never mind, I have an even better plan. How would you like to help me teach my father a lesson?
Maybe.
Great. Oh, I can't wait to see the look on his face.
Find a way in the locker room at Citadel. Okay. But it's locked.
Have you managed to get into the locked room yet? Oh, whatever's in
there.
Do
I have to steal
the
key from him? I'm not really good at pickpocketing. But I'm up for the challenge. Alright. Strong his lights. Go into all sneak mode. We can always just save reload until we get his fucking key.
Hello again, my friend.
No. Oh shit, there's a thing there.
The matter we did.
What if they don't see me though?
Gus.
Lika's key? I already have that.
You! How dare you! This is treason!
Are we all dead? I don't know if that's the key. That's the lake house key. I can already get in the lake house. I'll take it anyway. Oop. Hold that thought.
The many shall suffer for the sins of the one.
Holy shit. Dwarven Keeper Centurion. Wow, look at those things. That's not just a normal Dwarven Centurion. It's special. I thought it was the guard, the statues. That's definitely not the statues. What the shit? Well, I'm running out of time rapidly. Where do I find his key? Oh god, it's in here, isn't it? Fuck's sake. Alright. So we're gonna end this video on a high note. Lockpicking! Yay! Because I didn't get enough of this last session. I want to get into that big palace. Also, if you know how to get in the big palace, let me know as well. That'd be kind of cool. Maybe I should just look up some walkthroughs of this quest. I might. I didn't get caught. Just looking. Actually, hang on. Save. Quick save. Just in case this does give me a... in a bad way here. Okay. I didn't get noticed, so everything is fine.
Hello again, my friend. Any word about the matter? All right. Well, let me know when you've worked it out. I'll have to trust your judgment, and there's no going back once you point the finger.
Where's your key? What's this? There's a scroll up here. Scroll of Harmony. So that's what it is. That's kind of cool. Sit on that, you bitch. I feel like I'm lost. I kind of know what I'm doing, but I kind of don't. I have a lot of ideas of what I can do, but I don't know how to achieve any of them. And that's the problem. I can accuse two people. One of them, I'm fairly sure, is not the guy, the Dark Brotherhood. And the other guy, I don't think he's really the guy either. So I don't really know what to do at that point. Other than, and there's the fucking, the armor the guy's wearing. He won't give me the armor either. So how on earth? Damn it. Frustrating. It's a cool quest, but... Jesus. There's a lot of walking around, talking, and not knowing what I'm doing.
Who are you? Heard you held back an invasion all on your own. That's fine work.
Yeah. Who are you?
My story. Well, I was do- I have. I had. A wife and son. Meanwhile, I'm stuck down here, supervising workers to earn me keep. Waiting for the day that I can get out of here. And back to my life in... I wish. Seems like dwarfs designed this place to keep folk in. But the only thing that keeps me sane is thinking there has to be a way out.
Is everything okay between you and the workers?
Well, I'd be lying if I said they're happy. But I'd also be lying if I said I cared. They're decent people and all. But they seem to have an hard time grasping that somebody around here's got to work the farms. Or we all starve. Gulver's the worst of the lot. Seems like a decent man at first, but he's got a temper on him. Once he told me he killed a man before he came here. He'll tell you. Of course, down here with the dwarves, though, a bad temper could land us all in a lot of trouble. I'd keep an eye on that. All right, well, I'll see you around.
They're all pointing to Gulver. Ooh, this is not the bottom floor, is it? Son of a bitch. I mean, I could do a little bit of off-camera exploring to try and figure out how to do this. Because I don't know how many episodes I want to put into this place, you know what I mean? Well, I'm enjoying the quest. It is a lot of walking and not a lot of killing. And that's my favorite part. I'm all for a good storyline, but... if the journey there is a bit tedious, then I don't know. I can't sprint for shit. Why is he running? Should we follow this guy? Where are you going? Who are you?
Working hard.
Oh, that guy. Where the fuck is he running? Yeah, I don't know. I guess I'll, I mean, there's a lot of options. I just don't know. I guess I'd have to talk to everybody. Which is something I don't want to do.
Ugh. So my wife disappears a couple of weeks ago, and now everybody thinks I know a way out of here. I wish you idiots would just leave me alone.
Did she find a way to
escape? Well, she's not here anymore. That's all I know. How should I know where she went? I woke up one morning and she was just gone. Didn't say goodbye, didn't take anything with her. And now you people won't stop harassing me, judging me, and nobody cares that I've lost my wife. They just love a bit of scandal, or to find out how they can get out of here too. I swear I didn't hurt her.
Oh, I got it.
I would never. I love her, and if I'd known she was leaving, I would have gone with her. I honestly don't know anything. I keep going over it in my head. Did someone kill her? Surely that would have broken the dwarves' law. Maybe she went wandering into the underground tunnels, or into the palace, and never found her way out. But why would she leave in the night?
Was she involved with someone else?
Not that it's any of your business, but no, I don't think so. She was loyal, I think. She used to write me love letters. I still have one, somewhere. But even if she'd been seeing someone, she couldn't have kept it a secret in a place this small. Rustacia would have known about it for sure.
Search Orin's home for clues about whereabouts of his wife.
All right. Please.
Now we're talking.
Let me know if you hear anything about me.
But I do need to end the video here. It's been an hour. So I think that would be a wise decision. Let me get an ending screenshot, I guess. Nothing really eventful has happened quite yet, so I guess we'll just just take one randomly here. So that stamina bar goes away.
Why is the stamina bar still there?
I guess I could edit it a little bit. Oh, there it goes. Alright. That'll do. Cool. That has been a thing. So we continue on in this quest line. I don't know. Should I do this off camera? Like, do a little bit of exploring off camera? By the time you guys see this video, I'll have plenty of time to record it on the weekend when I don't put out videos now. So, let me know. Should I do a lot of the talking and stuff off camera and then try and figure it out and get it going? Also, if you have any tips, leave some on the comment section. That would help as well. But, yeah. We will get through this quest, and then we'll be back in the mainland of Skyrim in no time, hopefully. But I am kind of curious. There's some things that are very interesting. Like this palace. There's a big palace. There's underground tunnels I can't go into without radiation suit, which the guy won't give me. And he's also walking around like he's ready to stab somebody, which is a bit worrying. But, yeah. Alright. Hopefully that was enjoyable to watch, as always. And I will see you guys in part 19. See you all next time.